Secondary action gives more life to your character or objects. It is like adding ingredients to the main stuff. Here, for example, you can see the comparison between two actions, one where the character is just talking and one where she is chopping some vegetables and talking. So it gives more personality to the action, the primary action. Here you can see Ratatouille sniffing some food, and the action of his tail can be considered as secondary action, because the primary action is sniffing and the action of the tail is adding to it, is an addition, is a secondary layer of animation. It could also be like a character is running and the motion of his tie or a motion of his hat wobbling or waving up and down can be considered a secondary action as well. In this example, you can see like in motion design, you can see the first normal example where the clock is hovering up and down. But if we add some secondary action to it, which is the animation of the clock hands and the wiggling of the alarm, is adding to that animation, and it is much more interesting than just a hovering clock. So that is adding details to it, you know, enriching your animation. Secondary action is like adding bells and whistles to your animation. Okay, it could be like a character is walking, can be the primary animation, but while walking the character is like scratching his head or playing with his keys or whistling. Those additions, those personality additions, could be the secondary action.